Are you someone that likes to draw? Well, even if you aren't, I want to show you guys how to use the drawing section in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so here is where the drawing tab is located. If you go up here to home and go over just a little bit, you're gonna see a drawing tab. Click on that, and now you have all these different drawing functionalities right here. So we're gonna start off with the tools first. So you have Select, Draw with Touch, Eraser, and Lasso Select. So here's what you can do. You can draw with touch. So in this feature, you can actually use your own finger if you want to, if you do have a touchscreen laptop or whatever you are using as your device. But in this case, I'm just gonna use my mouse because that's just nice and easy. So I'm just going to draw like so. And maybe I wanna connect this. I can do like that. And then let's say we wanna draw this right here. And then maybe I'll draw my name. And then we could even draw like a square and maybe a triangle. All right, so those do not look perfect by any means, but this is just a quick way on how to draw. You can also select different types of pens that you want to use right here. So if you want to draw with a red pen, you could do that. Or if you want to draw with like this pencil looking thing, you could do that. Kind of has like a little bit of a grunge effect. And then you can also draw with a highlighter or even with this white pen right here, or even a black kind of looking pencil. So that is how you can easily switch between pens while you are drawing with touch. Now let's say I want to select what I drew. So I can just click and drag and that will select it. And then what I can do is I can either go to format and say shape outline to red, and that can affect how the outline of the shape's going to look. So another thing I can do is, let's say I want to erase something. I could go here to eraser, and I can erase this, or I can erase that. It's just gonna erase the entire drawing I made in that one swoop. And then let's say I wanna do the lasso effect, I could go here and just click and drag and highlight all this as a circle. Honestly, I feel like select and lasso are kind of similar. The only difference is that Lasso Select allows you to really be very specific with how it selects things. So if you have a very funky shape, probably go with the Lasso Select. But if it is an easy shape to select, I would probably just select this tool right here and then click and drag over it. All right, so let's say I want to select this right here. I use the Lasso tool. And then maybe I want to take this ink to a shape. So I can click on this. Then this is going to pop up right here. You click on it. So then what this is going to do, it's going to then identify what you drew as the closest shape to that visual. So in this case, since I was trying to draw a square, it was able to identify it properly as a square shape. Now this isn't going to always work for all things that you do draw. So let's say I click on this and want to convert this to a shape. Let's see if it converts it to a triangle. So it actually did that automatically right there, right when I hovered over it. And it actually can change it to different types of triangles, which is really cool. Or you can keep it as your ink object. Now let's try and see what this looks like if I convert this to shape. So this message says, we cannot recognize your ink. Please rewrite your selection and try again. So obviously it can't identify every possible shape in the world and insert that in, but for basic shapes like squares and triangles, it can easily identify that. Now let's say you want to do ink to math. So we did a video on how to actually draw your own equations right here, but I'm also going to show you guys, let's say you want to draw an equation. So I can go here and do 2 + 2. And then what I can do is I can do lasso select. So I can go here and select this. And then I can go to ink to math. And let's see what this comes up with. So it identifies as 2 + 2. And so now that I have this 2 + 2, I can actually edit this text to be 2 + 3. So this is just a quick way to draw equations if you want to draw them, or if you want to draw shapes. And then also what type of pen you want to use while you're drawing it. Another really cool function that you can add in is ruler right here. So if I click on this, now it's going to allow me to draw in really exact lines. So let's say I want to draw a very specific line, and then I want to move it up a little bit and then draw another line and then go back. All right, so now I have those two lines drawn really precisely. If you want to actually rotate this ruler, all you have to do is use this scrolling feature on your mouse. If you have a trackpad, you probably have to use like two fingers and slide it. But this is just how you can easily rotate your ruler by just going right here in the center and then using the scroll feature. And then you can do the same thing and draw another line. So really cool effect with that ruler if like you're trying to create something very precise. Another feature that I want to show you guys is ink replay. So if I click this, it's then going to show me all the different things I've created on this slide in a replay. Now, why would you want this? I have no idea, but it's just there for you if you do want to have that ability to replay what you just drew. All right, so another thing I want to show you guys is add pen. So here you can add a pencil, pen, or highlighter. So let's say I want to add pen. Click on this. You then can customize this pen to exactly what you want. How thick you want the pen to be, what color you want, maybe you want effects. Let's try this rainbow. So we're gonna do really thick, and then I'm gonna do black, and then effects rainbow. Okay, so let's see what this looks like now. Okay. All right, so that's pretty cool. I didn't even know you could do that. And you could also hit this drop down arrow and then you can change it. So let's try it with this. So if you ever want to customize your pen, just go here, add pen, whatever it is, hit the drop down menu, and then you do more colors if you want very specific colors, and then just hit okay, and then you're able to draw whatever you want. So as you can see here, this is just a really fun way on how to use the drawing section in PowerPoint. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you're interested in learning all things PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.